Welcome to this lesson. We're going to talk about a turnaround end sounding like a big band. A turnaround end is very common in jazz, and you are probably already familiar with it. For example, you can play it in the blues in measure 9. I will play the example. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. Measure 5, 6, 7, 8. And here it is. The basic chords are A minor 7, D7, B, B minor 7 or B half diminished, E7 with a flat 9 or a flat 10. Again, A minor 7, D7, and then you're back at G. And that's the end of it. For the big band ending I made, I use small chords, starting on the A minor 7. So this is an inversion. All A minor 7 chords. This is also an A minor 7 chord. Going to D7. So this. Then we play B half diminished with the E note on top. And in the melody we play E, D, E. And then we play two diminished chords. And it is, you can see it as a chromatic approach. So there's F7 to E7, but now we play, what is this, an A diminished chord to a G sharp diminished chord. But don't think too difficult about this. I see it as this, F7 to E7. So in my mind is also then back to A minor 7. We play this. So A minor 7 with a D in the bass. A minor 7, D in the bass. Now with a G in the melody. A minor 7, 9. This is A minor 11. Again, don't think too difficult about this. In my mind, it's all A minor. And because there's another note on top or in the bass, the name changes, but to keep it simple, just think A minor. So now we have again A minor and then so E minor with the D in the bass, same chord with a G note on top, an F sharp diminished chord, which is practically the same as a D7, to G, it's a G6. So again. And then, of course, the famous big band ending, Count Basie style. So this is a C minor 6. E diminished chord, or you can probably better see this as a G diminished chord, and back to G. It's also nice to play this one octave higher. I hope you liked the lesson, and please subscribe to the YouTube channel, and I see you next week. Have a good week.